हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, माय सेल्फ अमित उपाध्याय एंड आई एम बैक विद योर फेवरेट सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश। टुडे वी विल बी कंटिन्यूइंग आवर फर्स्ट यूनिट एंड वी विल बी चैंटिंग एंड वी विल बी गोइंग थ्रू अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल पोयम, आई वॉन्ट पीस। सो आर यू एक्साइटेड? लेट्स गेट दिस एक्साइटमेंट ओवरलोडेड एंड लेट अस स्टार्ट रीडिंग द पोयम। आई एम बिग ग्राउंड, I wonder if there will be peace. I hear the sound of people who are being killed. I see the people who crying for life. I want to help the poor people. I am big and round. I feel the weight of sorrow on me. I touch the feelings of the people. I worry about the future of the people on me. I cry for help from God. I am big and round. I understand the problems of the people on me. I say grace for all people. I dream about my past. I try to handle my sorrow. I hope I won't be destroyed. I am big and round. Can you tell who is saying that I am big and round? It's no one but our Mother Earth. It is the land on which we are standing. We play, we spend our whole life. It is our Mother Earth. So here our Mother Earth is very sad and it is saying that I want peace. She is very hurt by seeing the people being killed. It wants to help them, although it is very big and round, but it is very painful to her. And she wants this to be stopped and she wants peace. Let us see the meaning of the poem. I am big and round. The earth says that I am very huge, I am very big and round in shape. As you can see in the picture given beside the poem, you can see that there is earth and in which there is a map of so many countries and people of the world are standing together. This is showing the population of the whole world. We can see different races and different types of people in the picture. Now, next, what Earth is saying, I wonder if there will be peace. The Earth is praying and it is hoping that I hope there will be peace on earth, on me. The people, my creatures, will live in peace and will lead to a hopeful and happy life. It says that I hear the sound of people who are being killed. There is so much violence on earth. We, the human beings, we tell that we are the most clever and most wise creature created by the God. But what we are doing? We are fighting among us. We are fighting within each other. There is no peace. One country is attacking the other country for some silly reasons. We don't have friendship bond among each other. We are full of greediness. We are just a selfish creature, and for this sake we don't even hesitate to kill our fellow creature who belongs to the same species, being a human. So here it is telling that I hear the sound of people who are being killed. Human is killing the other human. There is no humanity remaining on earth. I see the people crying for life. The people who are being killed by the other people, they pray, they crave them, they beg them for their life to leave them. Because what is their mistake? What harm they have done to the other? The people have become such sinners that they are even killing the innocents. So here the earth is telling that the people are craving to save their lives. They are crying, "I want to help the poor people." Although the earth wants to help the poor people, but it can't, as it is big and round, but it is willing to help them. "I am big and round. I feel the weight of sorrow on me. Although I am very big and round, but what is the heaviest thing I am bearing? It is nothing but the sadness, sorrow. And what is that sorrow? What is the sadness that the Mother Earth is talking about? The sadness is that the human is not realizing the value of the nature, the value of the brotherhood, the value of his life that has been given to them by the Mother Earth." She adds and says that, "I touch the feelings of the people. I worry about the future of the people on me. I cry for help from God." Since she doesn't have mouth to talk, but still she touches the feelings of the people. She looks at the feeling of the people. She touches them. And she has the worry about the people who are living on me, on it. She cares about them. That is why she has provided the creatures, especially the human being, with all the necessary things that are required to have a happy life. The green fields, the trees, the oxygen, the food, different variety of food items, the beautiful sceneries that we enjoy on Mother Earth, that has been provided by to us by the Mother Nature, Mother Earth. But still, human being is not understanding, and it is destroying the wealth of the nature for the sake of its profit, which is not really a profit. It is just that for their mutual benefits and for the time being happiness, they are doing these things. They are destroying the earth, which will question their existence in the near future. So this is the problem, and for the solution is this problem, the earth prays to the God for the wellness of the human being. "I am big and round. I understand the problems of the people on me. I say grace for all the people. I dream about my past. I try to handle my sorrow. I hope I won't be destroyed. I am big and round." So, being a mother, the earth as our mother knows just by looking at our face that we are facing some difficulties or we are sad or not. In the same manner, our Mother Earth also realizes that we are not happy. She knows that we are living in sad situations. We are facing problems. But she always prays for the grace of all the people. She always prays for the wellness of all the people. She thinks that, she wants that every person, every people on the earth should live in peace and harmony. So, here in this poem, Mother Earth is very worried about the human beings. They are not realizing it. They just keeping on exhausting the resources of Mother Earth, but they are not realizing that they are not everlasting. There is end to everything. And when these things will end, how the human beings will exist? There will be a big question on their existence. She adds that, "I dream about my past." Now she thinks about the past, how beautiful scenery it had, how beautiful natural creations we had on earth, how many beautiful plant and animal species we had on earth. And now she looks in the present. the selfness, selfishness of the human being is destroying all the natural wealth on earth. The war, the weapons we have created, they are self-destructive. They are not for our security. They are not for our safety. Instead, they are destroying our species itself. So, the Mother Earth is worried about this. She says that, I try to handle my sorrow. Although this sadness is not ending, never ending, but still she is trying to manage. She is trying to hide its tears. And she says that, I hope I won't be destroyed. The scientific inventions, on the one hand, we think that these have given us a new light and new hope for the future. But on the other hand, it is given a worst scenario to the nature. It is less than a gift, more than a disaster. So, in short, we can say that we earned so many things from science, but we have lost the things which are more than that we earned. So, these things are leading our earth to a doom of darkness, to the doom of destruction. So, the earth is still having hope that I will not be destroyed and I will survive. I am big and round. So, finally, the earth again repeats that word, I am very big and round. So, we are done with the poem. And now, I want to ask you that whatever the human being are doing to our Mother Earth, do you think that it is correct, my children? We are cutting trees. We are cutting mountains. We are changing the pathways of the rivers. This is creating a lot of impact on natural balance. We are using plastic. We are throwing it here and there. Don't you think that when you throw the plastic on the road, some animal is going through there? If there is any food item in that plastic, the animals do not recognize that whether it is an eatable thing or not. Looking at the smell of that eatable, they just swallow that plastic with them. And what is the result? It leads to their death. So, this thing that we are doing to our earth is unfair. And this is the story being told by this poem, that how our Mother Earth is feeling right now. What bad things we are doing to it. And if we continue doing so, what will be our future? The Earth's temperature is continuously increasing due to global warming. Population is continuously increasing. People are killing innocent people. Terrorism, violence, increasing day by day. And at the same time, our capacity is also decreasing. In earlier days, we did not have so many vehicles. So we had the capacity to walk for long distance. We had a good habit. We had a good routine. But now, the science has made us lazy. So, the earth wants everything to be restored on earth, my children. So, this is the poem in which the Mother Earth tries to express its feeling and its sadness that it is going to be destroyed anytime soon. But it is still worried about the creatures on it. So, it is the time that we should become aware, we should wake up and try saving our Mother Earth. So, was the poem interesting to you? I hope you have enjoyed the poem, and I think that you will make sure that you will try your maximum effort to save Earth. You can do many things to do so. You can plant trees, you can protect existing trees from being cut down, you can aware other people to reduce using plastic, you can tell the people to live in harmony, you can behave with others in very soft behavior manner so that there will not be any enemy of yours, and you can teach the same thing to the others. If the people will have friendly behavior with each other, if they have the brotherhood among this, then no evil power can destroy the humanity from the earth. So this beautiful poem we had, and now we will try to answer a few questions related to the poem. So the poem is, the first question says that, what does the earth wish to have and why? What does the earth wish to have and why? The question is, what does the earth wish to have and why? So the name of the poem, from the name of the poem only, we can know that the earth wish to have peace and harmony. The earth wants peace. And why does it want peace? Because the earth loves its creatures like a mother. And no mother will want that its creatures or its son or daughter will face problems. So the earth prays for the human beings that we should live with grace, with happiness, and there should not be any sad moments, any sorrows for the human race and all the creatures on the earth. I hope you have understood this question and its answer. Now let us move to the next question and try to answer it. So the next question we have is, I am big and round. I am big and round. What do you think is suggested? What do you think is suggested by the repetition of the line? This line. So, as we have noticed that in every stanza, we have this phrase repeated multiple times. What is this? I am big and round. So, the question is, why it is being repeated in every stanza? So, the earth wants to tell that, although I am very big and round, I am helpless. I have the burden of sorrow on me. I want to help the creatures on me, but sadly I can't do anything. What I can do is just that I can pray for them. So, in general, it is considered that if one is big and huge, it has a lot of power and it can do anything very easily. But here, the earth tells that although I am big and round, I am helpless. I want to help the creatures who are living on me, but I can't. So, this is the motto of the phrase, I am big and round, being repeated in the stanzas. Now, next question we will see. I hope you got this very clearly. And let us look at the last question we have over here is, the last question we have is, was the earth happy or sorrowful? Give reasons for your opinion. Question number 3. Was earth happy or sorrowful? Give reasons for your opinion. So, the question is, was earth happy or sorrowful? Happy means glad. Sorrowful means sad. So, what do you think the earth was? You should tell me, children. Was the earth happy or sad? Right. We have gone through all the three stanzas and we have seen that in each and every stanza, the earth is very worried about the human being living on earth, about all the creatures, not only human beings. And how we can say that she is worried, she is sorrowful, that by looking at the lines she is saying. She, in the very first line, she says that, I wonder if there will be peace. I hear the sound of people are being killed. In the second stanza, it says, I feel the weight of sorrow in me. So, in this line, the earth is trying to say that there is a lot of sadness. It is nothing but like a burden on me that I am feeling. It says that I see people being killed. I see people crying for help, but still I can't. I touch the feelings of the people, but still I can't do anything. I just can do is that I can pray to God and I can just pray for them that they live a graceful life. So all these instances shows that earth is not happy but sorrowful. Further, she adds that, I hope I will not be destroyed. She indirectly tells that what human being is doing to it is unacceptable and there is a chance that it will be destroyed in the near future. But still She is having hope that human beings will realize it quite soon, and for their wellness and for the wellness of their Mother Earth, they will stop the things they are doing which is not favorable for the Mother Earth and the nature on it. So these are the feelings, these were the feelings of the Mother Earth, and she was not happy with the doings of the human being. I hope you have enjoyed the poem, and we successfully answered the questions which followed the poem. Now I have something to tell you. It's important that we should understand the concept about the lesson, about the poem, or about the story that you are listening to. But at the same time, it is required that you read it, you read the story on your own from 1 to 2 times, so that you will have your own understanding and the clarity will be more available to you when you read it on your own. So the explanation which has been done in the class is just for your ease. When you read it on your own, you can understand it more better and more deeply. And answering the questions which follow the poem or the lesson will increase your capability of problem solving. It will help you to improve your writing skills, problem solving skills, reading skills, at the same time understanding skills. So I hope that you are doing well, and you are understanding the lessons quite well. And today we finished the poem I Want Peace, which was the story telling by the Mother Earth, who was telling her current situation to us. And in our next class, we will be looking at the third part of the first unit, and we will be looking at the explanation of the lesson. Till then, I hope you enjoyed the class and you are safe at home. Goodbye.